So in this session, we'll discuss about like our designing of a mini project, which involves the majority of the components which we come across in the OAF. Okay, so let us discuss first of all what are the components will be covered, and also how we design our page. So the first component, what we, I mean, if you observe from the model view and controller level logic. So in the model level, we'll be discussing about AM, Vivo, Evo. Okay. And in the page level, right? So generally you have pages, regions, and SIBO. Okay. So like what are the components which we have in the OAF pages from the page point of view, from the UI point of view, there are only two types of components. One is we call it as item, and other one we call it as region. Okay. So let me tell you what kind of items or region we'll cover up. So the first thing, maybe we'll just start with the region, and then we'll cover up the items. So in the region, like we'll know what is header region, we know what is table region. This time we'll work on the advanced table region. Okay. And then yeah, sir, yeah, that message component layout region. Okay. And coming to the items, we'll be covering up text input, submit button, page button bar, attachment, switcher. Okay. And yellow is populous anyway, that will be covered up. And yeah,
Tab,
mostly
tabs is not going to go. Tabs.
tab, yeah, tab in this one, it will not make any significance. Like we'll try to have them like a tabs or sub tabs or maybe the train region that will cover up independently. That won't be part of this one. We'll cover up them independently. Yeah, maybe hyperlink image. Okay. And like a text input, we have two types, right? Read only text also will cover up. Okay. I'll try to see whether we can cover up the, what do you call, the flexi field, but maybe for flexi field also we'll try to have a different session on that. Okay. So high level, these are the components which will be covered up, but what is the functionality we want to achieve, right? So there are like assume that we'll have two pages. One is search page, other one is like maybe a sales order details page, like this. So what we want to achieve is like and when you say search page, like a user can search the sales order based on the created by or status or maybe a sales order number, right? Or maybe created by or some other fields. We'll try to design a search page with that. So in the
Can
search
we create
page,
instead of sales order, can we create the purchase order? Anything other than the sales order?
no, we are not creating, we are not calling any standard API.
Okay.
We'll
No,
not be.
no, just tables only. We are, but you are going to use the OA order header center, all right, in this
No, no,
model.
no. How will it work? It will not work, right? You cannot insert any DML operation into standard table directly. It should be always through API only or open interface.
Okay.
Yeah. So we can have the just columns we can just consider, but we are not calling the standard fun, we are not doing any standard functionality here. Okay.
I don't have the data in this one. That my I don't have the sales orders.
No, no, I mean to see, we are simply creating our custom table. Okay. We
Okay.
don't touch any standard table at all.
Okay.
Okay. So in the pivot details page, what we'll have is we'll have header region for the header data. We'll have a table region for the purpose of lines. Okay. And now in the status, right, in the search page, what we do is like when you get a set of results, we'll allow the user to either view the data or create a new record, or we'll also allow him to update the data. So like whenever, let us say in the search page, when you get a set of records, when you click on the view, you'll go to pivot details page in the view mode. When you click on create, you'll open in the create mode. When you click on update, we'll open the update mode. So we will not have three pages for the pivot details. We'll have a single page which will try to show up the data based on the mode which you are setting from the search page. Okay. So that particular functionality, like the spell logic will be considered part of this. Using spell logic, we'll be achieving it. Like last time we discussed about spell, right? Like dynamically enabling, disabling those things. Okay. So now, yeah, this is the main functionality, like a view, create, or update based on the mode which you select in the search page. Based on that, the pivot details page will render the appropriate content. Okay. Now, similarly, in the pivot details, you'll have header data, you'll have table data. In the table, you can allow, when you have a table region, it means that you will allow the user to enter multiple lines or update or delete multiple lines, right? And in this particular pivot details, when you open the page in the create or update mode, obviously we have to provide them all the CRUD operation functionality, right? Like you should allow user to insert, you should allow them to update as well as delete also, okay? So this is what we want to achieve. And next thing is like here, yeah, in this particular functionality, we'll be using only two tables as of now. Okay, later on we can consider whether we need to add up some columns or change some columns, something like that, or maybe we need to add up one more table. It depends. So as of now, initially to start with, what we want to do is, we'll just try to have just two tables. One is for the purpose of header and other is for the purpose of lines. So I'll just name it as XX pivo header and other one is XX pivo lines. Okay, that's it. So these are two tables as of now. So later on we'll see how to extend them based on the columns which we want. Okay, so I'll just open the SQL developer. So this time we'll try to have them particular, what do you call, the who objects properly. Okay. So let me save this first. Okay, create table pivot headers. So what we can do is we can try to just see the existing standard table. Maybe we can add up some columns similar to that. Okay, later on, see, it is possible to call the standard API and perform the insertion also. Okay, it is not that much difficult. Okay, we just need to call the API only, that's it. So we'll just say we'll have pivot header ID. Okay, and last status, and then yeah, the supplier site ID and these things, right? Let us have this also, supplier ID and supplier site ID. Okay, and maybe some more column. Yeah, status is important. Let us have status also. Status, currency code. Okay, for now I think this should be okay. Maybe I think we don't have amount details in the header, right? Do we have? Yeah, it will come up from the line level only. Okay, maybe we can add up comments. Yeah, let's stop this one. And then we require who columns, right? We require who columns. So who columns you can just get from here, like last update login, creation date, created by. There are two more.
Last updated by.
Last updated date. Last updated date, last updated by, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
just see this one. So now when you're designing a project, like which is a pure custom one, first of all, you always need to check out how you want to design your data model, right? So now in our case, I just have only two tables, for each pivot header, I can have multiple lines, right? One too many. Okay. And here it is not null number, when site ID, I think I need to mention comma here. Okay, anything more? Yeah, I think this is okay, I guess. Just create the table. Okay, it says some missing right parenthesis, line number 4 and column 26, enable line numbers, line number 4. What happened to this? Okay, let me remove this as of now. Somewhere it is giving it. Okay, I think this syntax is not correct. Not null. Let me remove not null here. Later on, we'll see how to change it. Okay, the table got created. And similarly, we'll have the who columns in the lines also. Okay, create table. Okay, these are the who columns. And we require pivot header ID because that becomes a foreign key now. And
pivot line. Pivot line.
Yeah, just check out the pivot lines and based on that, we'll add up some columns. Describe pivot lines. Maybe line type, line amount, or currency, something like that we can add up. First thing is pivot line ID. After pivot header ID, we'll have pivot line ID. As of now, I have not enabled primary key, right? That should be, that is required, but yeah, it's fine. We'll enable that. Pivot header ID, line number will have line number. Next. If at all, if you want to check out, if you want to link the inventory item, then, you know, like you can select item number, item ID, and then we can select item description and we can select quantity. Yeah. Okay. And we can select the UOM also unit. Where is that unit? Unit. I think this could be that, right? Unit of measure. Unit measure lookup code. I think this one. Okay, this should be fine, right? Amount required. Amount. Yeah, this is enough. Okay. So this also got created. Now, what is the next thing? So we created our tables in the app schema only. So now what we do is let us start the remaining functionality. So initially we'll try to work on the pivot details page. Okay. We'll try to design the pivot details page in the mode of creation. Later on, we'll just see how do we integrate search page with this pivot details page. Okay. So today we'll try to finish the header part. Okay. Header data creation part. Later on, we'll see the functionalities one by one. So first I'll create this particular two tables evo objects, these two evo objects first, xxpivo headers as well as xxpivo lines. And now in this one, right, what I'll do is I'll try to have a different package structure. I will not use this one. I want to have a separate one. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll try to have a package structure with the name xxmini.oracle.apps.fnd.server. Similarly, schema servers, then the remaining things. Okay. First, we'll create the aim. Okay. XXMINI. XXMINI. Then on this project, perform a right click, click on new business component application module. Next. And here, mention this one. XX mini Oracle Apps FND server. Okay. I'll just say mini business services application module. Nothing to change. Let's go with the default and click on finish. Okay. We'll save it as of now. We can see a mini Oracle Apps FND server. Now, in this one, we'll create our Vivo object, Evo and Vivo now, respectively. New entity object. We have it. Just mention the package structure here properly. Schema server. Just type XXPivo header. Okay. It automatically gave that. Just mention Evo here. And now Yeah, it will ask you, as we don't have the primary key, right? It will ask what is a primary key. Okay, so let us just click on next and just make the PO header ID as a primary key. Okay, PO header ID as a primary key. Don't enable row ID. That is not a good practice. Actually, we'll try to have the primary key, but we'll see like how do we change. See what happens is, in any IT implementation project, we can't decide our database objects perfectly in the day one. Obviously, like on set of iterations, then only you'll be trying to change your particular database columns or column types or data types, all those things, right? So we'll understand how do we synchronize our database also. That is the reason I'm not trying to have the, what you call a freeze database table at this point of time. Now click on next. And here generate all the methods, we require all of them. And here generate the view object at this point only. This is the best practice, EO, VO, and XX mini. FND server. Next, finish. So at this point, it will have one EO object, one VO object, which was generated. Similarly, let us finish for the PO lines also. Even though we'll not discuss the lines today, we'll try to finish up only header part first. The schema server, I'll perform a new entity object and then mention the line data, line table name, and just mention the suffix. Evo, and next. Yeah, okay, 1 minute. Let us set the PO line ID as a primary key. PO line ID as a primary key. Next, let us generate all the methods of this one also. Similarly, next, and FND server, Evo, Vivo. Next, and finish. Now the next step is assign these both VOs to the AM mini project, VO header VO, VO line VO also. Now we have assigned our two VO objects to the AM, click on apply. This point will generate two constructor methods in the AM IMPL, the two getter methods. Just observe that we'll have get XX PO lines and similarly get XX PO header also. Okay. Now the next thing is let us create our page. PO details page. Okay. Now, in this FND package, I'll perform a right click, click on new, OA components, and page. PO details page. And here, change the package structure appropriately. Change the package structure. xxmini.org/labs-fnd-web-ui. Now, set the constructor also, sorry, controller, right click on the region one, set controller. PO details, CO. Now click on the page on this one, set the default properties, main region, XX mini, then PO details page, then PO details page. Okay. So most of the content is ready. And now in this one, what we do is in this main region, I'll create two regions. One is for the purpose of header, PO header data, and other is for the purpose of PO line data. So I'll just right click here. In this region one, I'll just say, header data region, I'll say header details. Similarly, region two, I will name it as line data region, line details, okay. Now, before proceeding further, just run the page and see how it looks like. Are there any compilation issues or any package issues? We'll understand at this point. Okay, so far, okay. We don't have any issues now. It is able to open. Now, next thing is let us add up the header data first. Now, what I'll do is in the header data, see, like as we want to design header details kind of stuff. So in this page, the expectation is that you'll have only one header record and n number of line records. So in the header data, we don't require a table region. That is of no use at all. So in the header details region, we'll try to use a new component called message component layout region. But for that, we don't have any wizard option. What we do is we have a shortcut, like first of all, just design a new region using a wizard. Okay, click on next. And here, X6 mini, select the header data, Vivo, next. And in this one, as of now, what you do is, you just select default stack or maybe default single column. As of now, I'll select default single column. That is my region style I'm selecting. Click on next. And here, don't select the who column. It's of no use because who columns will be updated by the entity object automatically. So remove the who columns. Later on, we'll see whether we want to enable, but as of now, at this point, we don't require the who columns, okay? And there are few columns for which we as a user or as a user, we will not enter the value, nothing but one example is PO header ID. PO header ID should be auto-generated, okay? We'll see that later, but as of now, let the user enter the data. Now click on next, and I'm keeping all of them as message text input at this point of time, but later on, we have to modify a few of them one by one. The next and finish, okay? Now just run the page and see how it looks like. Okay, yeah, so this is how it is looking like. So definitely it is not a good thing to be displayed to the user because having all of them in a single column, nobody likes it. We require them to be stretched appropriately, like maybe a three column fashion or a two column fashion. Okay, so that we'll try to achieve now. What you do is just click on this one, click on this region style, and instead of default single column, just change it to message component layout. There is one of the good component style, which is used frequently, very frequently in many of the pages, that is called message component layout. So when you click on this one, it says this warning because there are some set of particular components which will not work out in this particular component style. Okay, but in our case, as of now, it will work out. Let's click on yes. And then in this one, you have something called rows and columns. It will ask you how many columns you want to display and how many rows you want to display. So in our case, how many columns we have? Total 4 + 3, 7 columns we have. 4 + 3, 7 columns we have. Let us say I want to display them in a 3 by 3 fashion, like a 3 rows and 3 columns. And now just run the page and see how the look will change now. So I have given a 3 by 3 fashion, 3 rows and 3 columns. Okay, at least somewhat look and feel is quite better than the earlier one. Now, so before proceeding further, what we do is we will add up two buttons, like save as well as cancel. Now the save and cancel, where should we add up? So for these kind of pages, what we prefer is we need to add up them in the page button bar region. There is something called page button bar region. So now on the main region, perform a right click, click on new region, change this region style to page button bar. The region style to page button bar region. So I'll just say page btn rn. Now under the page button bar region, I will add up two buttons. One is save button, other one is a cancel button. Save. This is for the save. I'll copy control C, control V. Now it created a new button. So I will name the first one here, save button. And the other one is cancel button, cancel btn.
Why cancel is what you are trying to cancel? Save is insert.
See, now the functionality here is, now what are we expecting here? This PO details page, user will not come to PO details page directly. It has to come from search page only. As of now, we are not implemented the total functionality. we are creating a new record. We are just, you know, like working on only pivot details page first. Later on, we have to integrate search page with the pivot details page also, right? When you navigate, when you are viewing, let us say when you are coming from a search page to the pivot details page, what you do is you'll select a pivot record. It'll come to pivot details page. And then how do you navigate back to the search page again? You require a back button.
Okay.
So that is the purpose of the back button in this case. And just see how page button bar looks like. Got it? This is how page button bar looks like.
Cancel will go to previous page. Cancel
yes.
will go.
Yes, the expectation is that when you click on cancel, it has to navigate to the search page. When you click on save, you'll be in this page only, data will get committed.
Okay.
Now, the next functionality is let us implement the insertion logic. Now, the expectation is that whenever I open a page, I should enter the data. When I click on save, I should just commit the data. That's it. That is what we want to achieve now. So for that, what we require, first of all, you need to initialize the VIVO. We need to initialize the VIVO. Whenever you come to the page, we just need to create a new record. Okay, so I'll just public void initialize VIVO header VIVO. XX VIVO header VIVO. VIVO is equal to get XX VIVO header EVO VIVO. Now we require row ampil also to be enabled for the header VIVO as well as line VIVO. Just click on the header VIVO. Click on the header viewer and click on Java, generate Java file, apply and OK. Similarly, for lines also, click on Java, generate Java file. No, where are we? Sorry. This one, right? Evo Vivo. This one. This Evo one, Vivo row IMPL, OK? Just check that again. This one, not this is not required. Definition is not required. We require this one, okay? The row IMPL. Now, get the same thing like what we have implemented earlier. Like the insertion logic is always same. There is no difference in that. Now, what we do is, we need to create a new row. vivo.createRow. Row.setNewStatus. Status dot initialized. Row dot status initialized. Vivo dot insert row and row. Okay. So what are we doing? Get the Vivo instance, create a new row, set the new row status and insert the row. That's it. Okay. Later on, we'll modify this logic to have some default values also. And this particular logic, we have to call it based on the whenever the page gets loaded. Okay, we just want to execute our Vivo whenever the page gets loaded. So I'll just say mini am is equal to page context dot get application module webbean. Now cast it am dot okay. Now, let us implement the save logic also. Now. So whenever user clicks on save button, let us do the commit also. Get parameter, save button, not equal to null. Get OID transaction. Section. Okay, now let's run the page and see how this works now. So we have just initialized our Vivo. and we just have implemented the commit functionality. Okay, it says one error. Let us see that. Expected. Okay. Yeah, semicolon was missing here.
If we click automatically, it will go to that that code. If we click.
Yeah, whenever you get an error, right? You can observe the file. Simply, you can click on there. It will go there.
Automatically, it will go to the wherever.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Now, what I'll do is, as of now, I'll just enter one. And I'll just say PO number, or I'll say PO underscore 001, vendor ID, I'll say 100, site ID 200, status, I'll just say new, currency code INR, PO comments. Okay. Just click on save and see what happens. It says data saved successfully, but let us observe from backend. Let us observe from backend. Got it. And also observe the who columns.
Automatically.
That's it. They are taken care by the EOIMPL itself. Okay. Now let us say, now the data got saved. If you try to enter the PO header ID as 2, what will happen? Let us say I will enter the PO header ID as 2. And this is as like maybe PO 002. If I click on save, what is expectation? It will just simply update the existing record, right? It will just simply update the existing record. It will not create any new record now. Got it? Because you already opened the page and it just created a single record. Initially, when you click on save, it created the new record. Again, you modified the data. When you click on save, it simply updates the existing record. Okay. Now let us, I'll open a page again. Now, without entering data, I'll just click on save first. Let's see what happens. It says data saved successfully, right? It says data saved successfully. Just observe what is there in the database. Nothing, right? Nothing is there. So it's kind of, you know, like a misguided information. Even though it simply says data saved successfully, we could not see any data. What I'll do is I'll just enter this time a PO header ID 3 and just click on save. Now just check out from the backend. Can you see? Now we got the data. So the functionality of this, like it is kind of a, we made the PO header ID as a primary key. A primary key by default, it should not be null, right? It should have given an exception, but it was not giving it. It simply says data saved successfully. But when we entered the PO header ID and clicked on save, it worked, right? So there are a few things which we have to explicitly handle it. Okay. Now, so, it is almost finished. Like this particular portion is finished. And now what we do is, so we'll not extend further. What we do is in the next session, we'll try to implement the line details. Okay. And also we'll implement the search functionality. Okay. So then, you know, like we'll be progressing further. So next session, what we do is we'll implement the line functionality. We implement the search functionality, and also we'll implement the navigation functionality from the search page to this page. Okay, so that, you know, like some portion of the navigation will finish and the create portion also will finish. Okay.
Search page, is there is a separate region.
Search page will implement a new page.
New page.
That's a new page we'll implement.
Okay.
Okay.